other sports we're familiar with. In tennis, there is no coaching allowed once a match begins. Imagine a baseball game without the batter checking the third base coach for instructions, or a football game with a two-minute warning without the quarterback and the coach talking on the sidelines. While this type of mid-course correction is forbidden in tennis, it still happens, however, every day, even among some of the more prominent players. Now, this continuing controversy over coaching is the subject of our next report from Beyond the Baseline. Merrill Lynch takes you beyond the baseline. At Merrill Lynch, we believe your world should know no boundaries.
I need somebody, help. Not just anybody, help. You know I need someone.
During a match, every player can use a little assistance. And on the men's tour right now, there is an uproar about players who are receiving coaching from right here in the stands. The rule book is quite clear on this subject. It is illegal to receive coaching of any kind during a match. Yet more and more seem to be doing exactly that.
Everybody. It's coaching a little bit.
There's some, signaling going on and speaking as well.
Everybody gets away with it. I mean, your coach has signals that you can use, and so coaching really is out there on every match.
Most coaching occurs during changeovers, when a player can peer into the stands and get instructions via hand signals that have various meanings.
Sometimes it means not twice big hand, but the list of stops or
starting that quick, getting a go forward.
The effect of coaching can be immediate and dramatic. In this sport, the slightest change, such as tossing the ball for the serve a little higher, can pay rapid dividends and perhaps change the outcome of a match.
You could be doing the most obvious thing wrong and you don't realize it. You look over to a little coach you see on the mound and he'll just flick something with the signal and you go, God. And then you start trying it and it's the easiest thing in the one match.
With so much at stake, Grand Slam titles and million-dollar purses, why are so few players cited for coaching violations? Well, sometimes it's hard to distinguish between subtle coaching and natural human behavior.
We have a great difficulty doing it because it's very difficult to say whether or not the hand signal is really, if they're scratching this. I mean, that's hardly coaching, but obviously if it goes like that, that's obvious.
No matter how obvious the coaching may be in the stand, detecting it can be difficult, especially since many umpires claim it's hard enough for them to concentrate on monitoring the action on the court.
It's hard enough to keep track of everything going on to begin with to make sure it's fair for both players. If you have to be watching the stand too, it's extremely difficult. It's just physically next to impossible.
But other umpires feel it can be done.
It's very simple to catch someone coaching. You just have to know when to look.
And Lee Jackson should know. He was the supervising official when Steffi Graf was penalized in a match against Claudia Kotichos last year.
They were hand signals. There was no doubt that he was signaling. He was penalized. He's not penalized. The player is penalized if she is caught being coached.
On the main tour, the most penalized player has been Boris Becker, first in Wimbledon 2 years ago.
Hand signal from the box. The manager and the coach, they were caught by umpire Mike Lutz.
And then last year, the tournament in California. Becker, however, sees nothing wrong with the practice.
In every other sport, they have a coach in baseball, they have a coach in basketball, and football, and so why do teams have a coach in tennis?
Coaching from the sidelines is an integral part of pro sport. Ironically, tennis's team competitions, such as the Davis Cup, allow coaching. Now, some would like to see this carry over.
It doesn't be coaching like Davis Cup. I mean, there's no reason why you can't have a guy telling you in between games or something like that, you know, how to play the guy or something. I mean, it's in all sports, it's the guy of the game, you know, it's coach of health.
I would love it if I could be coaching a match just to talk to someone. That's why I like to play doubles or play on a team, you know, just talk to someone from the changeover instead of looking like an idiot and talk to yourself the whole time.
Those opposed maintain that while individual sports such as golf and boxing allow assistance, tennis is